We're here at the Indigo O2 for the open workout for the Bellew David Haye fight. We're here with two young prospects, Lawrence Okolie and Umar Sadiq. Umar Sadiq is still amateur right now, right? Are you turning over? Is that right?
Technically speaking, yeah.
Technically speaking?
Yeah.
But you're turning over?
Yeah, I'm turning over.
Okay. And Lawrence, you turned over already,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
Have you had any fights yet?
No, I'm still waiting to make my debut.
Do you know when your debut is?
It's looking like the end of March, but we're going to have to wait and see how the dynamics go. No, you can't. No, I can't.
Spot like Joshua.
I'm not even going to go into that. We'll talk about
it. Ask him. Whatever he says happens.
Maybe.
Ask Bill.
Maybe.
Yes, look, from that, yeah.
Tell me, do that.
You're
looking at a person, you can tell if they're telling the truth or not. All I've heard is sparring this man, Joshua. See you later. And I've heard it a few times.
Mad, isn't it? Mad. That's all hearsay. That's all the grapevine. That's all, you know, street. Word on the street stuff, but you know, we'll just stick to what's going on now. Yeah. So, what do you think of this card on this weekend? Sadiq, what do you think of the card? You tell me.
The card's stellar.
Yeah?
I think for fights that, in terms of pay-per-view standards of recent times, I think this is actually one of those cards that you should pay for. I'm not even getting paid for this, but it's just an opinion.
Turn promoter.
Yeah, trust. I think, because really and truly, what makes a good pay-per-view card is a card that captures a public's imagination, and that's
right.
What this has done.
Yeah.
You've got a household name in David Haye.
Right.
Tony Bellew, who's got Liverpool on lock.
Yeah.
He's caused a big fuss after his last fight, and you know, the public's wanted to see what's going to happen, and you know, now we get to see it on Saturday. The honor card's live. I'm really excited to see the likes of Paulie Malignaggi on it.
Right.
You know, so yeah, it's going to be a great card, and looking forward to seeing the result. I reckon Haye spot. I know you're going to ask. I reckon Haye spot to Abeli.
That's your prediction of
that's
that one.
Yeah.
So, but is the Malignaggi Eggington, is that the fight you're actually looking for?
No, that's one of the, I'm going to watch all the fights that were most intense, really. I'm just a massive boxing fan now. I watch everything, but
perfect.
It's just card just happens to be one where even if I wasn't such a big boxing fan, I would still want to watch all these fights if I remotely knew about the people that are on it. So, yeah, man, big things. I'm happy. I'm excited. I'm going to be here from when the door opens.
Say no more. And my good friend Lawrence over here, well, your good friend now anyway.
Yeah.
What do you think? What do you think of this card?
Yeah, I think it's a great card. I'm upset that I'm not part of it. But yeah, it's a great card. When you actually look at all the fights in it, they're all competitive. Like, there's not a fight that you know this person's going to win or that person's going to win. All of them have a little bit of excitement.
We don't know that.
And then Paulie's going to score Eggington.
Mm-hmm.
Then Katie Taylor's going to throw flurries against her opponent.
And stop her.
And dart circles around her.
Yeah. Right.
And then O'Hara Davis is
going to spark I'm looking
at Derry Matthews.
Is that what you think? 100%? Yeah? You think he's out of his zone there?
I think
personally people are getting obsessed with O'Hara's power, but it's not his power. I think his range and his athleticism as well.
Right.
Like, as much as he might be the same height as all these guys, his arms are free. Now, everyone's starting to...
Yeah, I mean, people don't really appreciate that.
They're clocking on, but you won't understand it.
They feel they can get past it, but...
You won't understand it.
It's freakish. Like, I've sparred the guy.
Right.
And I've got a reach, and I know how to use my reach. Mm-hmm. And the guy's still managed to find a way in. So, anyway, that's another story. Davis is in a spark at Matthews.
That's what it is.
Derry's skill set, Derry's experience, but the skills. Do you know what I mean?
Some
100 fights.
There's a level of skill set.
This card is all about comparing the levels. You got Haye, Bellew, different levels. O'Hara, Matthews, different levels. Malignaggi, Eggington, different levels. All about the levels in this card. That's basically what it looks like. It's just like, it's going to be a card of, is either going to go how we expect, or there are going to be some upsets.
Right.
That's basically what it is, but it's all about comparing the levels.
Yeah. Which one was the most likely upset, do you think? The most likely upset on this card? Who's meant to win that at Malignaggi?
Yeah.
Isn't Eddington supposed to be in?
I'm Sam to the Wolves.
Yeah, I'm sure Eddington's supposed to win that one, right?
I'm sure Eddington's meant to
win. But it's technically not, because Paulie's been out for 3 years. But I just feel like
But people are sleeping on Malik Naji, man.
Yeah, but
can't sleep on Paulie, bro.
What? Can't? You can't really give him. You can't say Broner. So what? Yeah,
but,
Broner, Garcia.
He's for all of the welterweights.
All the big names, man. Come on. Like, and he's been about. Like, he's been in the game still. Like, if you see him, he's never out of shape. So clearly,
that's right. That's what I'm trying to say.
You know what I mean, like, you can't knock the guy.
Can't sleep on this guy. So
also, he's been breathing, boxing, like analyzing it. So
yeah, that's it. So I don't. I personally don't think that it's a foregone conclusion for Ellington. That's basically what I have said.
Yeah. I think I'm actually favouring Malik Naji to win the fight as opposed to as much as obviously Matchroom, whatever. But I think that Paul is going to be a bit too much of a clever boxer.
Look, because Ellington, I don't know what title has he got now.
I can't remember.
Is it the silver? WBC silver or something like that.
I've seen Ellington box past European level. Paulie has only boxed at world level for like the last 10 years or more.
Yeah, exactly.
So I think that's what speaks the volumes.
Cool. Okay, so as for you two though, what weight do you compete at, my friend?
Super middleweight.
And when you turn over, is that the weight you're looking to?
That's the weight I'm going to be out until I unify it, and then I'm going to move on to light heavyweight.
Jeez. Until he unifies.
The champ is here.
I like that. Until I unify. That's the type of talk that we need from our fighters.
That's
you know? And when do you know when you're going to turn over?
Hopefully within the next couple of months, maybe the next few months, but sooner rather than later, just chipping away at it. I'm not rushing, but I'm working.
Perfect.
So that's it.
You're already a 10-man fight. I see you in the gym. Maybe 12.
He's already a 10-man fight already?
No, you do look, but obviously, there's not a title on the line, so I'm going to say 10.
Easy, bro.
No, he's in great shape, but
for me,
yeah,
I'm also pushing. No, for you, you're at cruiserweight, right?
Cruiserweight.
And you're feeling good at that weight?
Yeah, for me. I mean, I boxed at an Olympics as an amateur.
Right.
And with those, I had to make it three, four, five times in a week. Mm-hmm. So it's not just make it day before and blow up.
Yeah.
The case if I had to maintain
maintaining it. Yeah.
So I'm good at the weight, just really big, really strong.
Mm-hmm.
Fit still. So, you know, I'm just, I've changed my diet.
Yeah.
So I've pushed more towards being a vegan. Not 100% yet.
Okay.
I'm adapting that quite well.
Yeah.
It's making it even easier for the weight, and I feel even more fit. So, I'm good. Am I going to unify? Absolutely.
Of course.
Absolutely.
That cruiserweight division's yours, bro.
You're right.
We should just call the gym Undisputed.
You're right.
That's cool, man. Well, guys, thank you very much for your minutes. Thank you for your time.
Welcome,
and, you know, we'll be following you guys. Boxwatch TV will definitely be following the progress of these two young prospects.
On social media, on Facebook, on Twitter, and on Instagram, at Top Boxer Sadiq with a Q at the end.
Top Boxer Sadiq with a Q at the end?
That's mine is Lawrence_TKL.
Yeah.
However, once I start getting more KOs in the pro ring, I'll change it to Lawrence.
Take the T out. Yeah. I heard that. Is that on all social media?
Yeah,
on all social media, Top Boxers League.
Perfect, guys. Thank you very much for your time.
You.
Nice meeting you. And you know, we'll see you more in the future, man.
All the best.
Cheers.